Let's talk about cables. Welcome back to Stereo and Beyond. My name is Ronald, and well, today I decided to make a more controversial video. A lot of people on the internet, and well, a lot of people in the audio hi-fi hobby in general, have different opinions about cables. Today I'm just going to talk about loudspeaker cables, because that's the most important cable topic. And I'm just going to share my experience and maybe give you a little bit of, my point of view about this whole cable thing. There are many different cable options out there. You can buy power cables, you can buy interconnect cables and loudspeaker cables. That's the main three, cables that I would recommend people to look at for tuning their system. And tuning their system is the right word, because if you want a good system, speakers and amplifiers and sources, those are the main priority you should focus on. And well, after a while you can start and placement, of course, speaker placement is really important, but after a while you can look into this stuff, isolation, different cables, tuning your system. And in my opinion, that's what cables are for. Because if you start with a good, decent cable, like I did, you can head in the right direction that you want to go in terms of your system's quality and your system's overall performance that you desire. And if you are on a level where you say to yourself, okay, with the equipment that I have, the speakers, the amps, the sources, I'm happy, but I would like to tune it a little bit, maybe add some more dynamics, open up the soundstage a little bit, just tuning a bit, then cables are a really, really good way to go. I do not believe that cables make or break a system. Of course, if you have really shit cables, they will hold back your system. But if you use decent quality cables, a thick gauge for the appropriate length, decent isolation, just a decent cable, it won't hold back your system, to begin with. But if you want to up the performance, then cables come into play. And different types of cables come into play. Power cords, in my opinion, make the biggest difference on the amplifier stage. Power amps, preamps, that stuff. Interconnects also make the biggest difference in the path between the amplifiers. Sources, I have experimented with it. Different cables on sources, power cables on sources. Yes, they do in my system tune it a bit, but not as much as, for instance, a better power cable on my power amplifier or my preamp. And well, the interconnect cables also matter the most in my amplifier stage. The Yakin and the Onkyo M5060, that's the place where the interconnect makes the most difference. But speaker cables, I have different cables here. These are, well, most of the cables that I started with. I started with a really simple amplifier, a Onkyo Integra something from this line. It was a really, amazing amplifier back in the day. It's still an amazing amplifier, but it had some issues, and I went to a Denon X 4300, or no, 4000. 4300 is a newer version, the 4000, Denon X 4000 receiver. I used, with my Onkyo, really thin 1.5 millimeter cables, really thin shielding, just really basic cables that I wouldn't recommend to anybody, not even for surround. But they did the job, and I had speakers with those clippy things, those clips for the loudspeaker cables, so I couldn't use a thicker gauge. But then I upgraded to this. This is in acoustic, I don't know what it is, in acoustic Transamp 25, made in Germany, that's what it says. But it's a 2.5 millimeter. I believe 2.5 millimeter is a good length for around 1 to 5 meters. I don't recommend going longer than that with that gauge for really big speakers. You could find all sorts of information and a lot of bullshit on the internet. Oh, for this length you need this gauge, etc, etc. It's true. Or for this size of speaker you need a thicker gauge. If you have 2.5 millimeter for, I don't know, 3 meters. My cables are always between 2 and 3 meters for your main two speakers. If you have your speakers further apart than that and you need bigger cables for your speakers, then either your amp is placed in a different country or you have your speakers too far apart, in my opinion. You want to keep the signal path not too short, but not crazy long. 3 meters for me, it's good. I can get my cables and maybe place another speaker here or something like that. So, I bought this. This is, I don't know, 4 euros a meter. Might seem expensive, but if you have good quality, well, big speakers or even just little bookshelves, if you have good quality speakers, you want a decent wire. And I'm not saying spend hundreds of euros on your cables when you first start playing with your hi-fi. Don't do that. Invest in amplifiers, sources, speakers. You should put your money there. When you have your ideal system, then you can spend money on cables, because in my opinion, that's for tweaking. And this is just a really good cable to start with. It is a good shielding cable, it's a good conductor, it's a good cable. This is a good cable. It doesn't color the sound or anything, because if you use different materials and different types of filtering you come across in really high-end cables, they change the sound, because that's what they were meant to do. They were not meant to produce a normal sound that you would get from normal oxidized free copper. And this is just normal good cable, and you'll be fine with this. For your surround speakers, I'm using 2.5 millimeter cables all across my surround systems, even on my center channel. And well, it's fine. It's fine for everything. It's fine to start with. It's even fine to last. But if you will improve your sound system and not spend money on new speakers or new amplifiers, then cables is a good way to go. So yeah, if you have a good quality cable to start with like this, you're fine. Or another example is this. This is also 2.5 millimeter. This is from Ulenbach, same as this, but these are different. This is a mixture of silver and copper. This is normal copper. Exact same shielding, exact same manufacturing, but this uses a little bit of a different material. People who do not believe in cables, they at least need to admit, when you're using different material, the cable will sound different. Fact. I've done blind tests with people, I've done blind tests myself, that I told somebody else switch out the cables, and they sound different. This is a little bit more focused on highs and sometimes can sound a little bit more sharper. This is, well, more neutral. And with neutral, I mean, this is the more generic sound. If you buy a speaker cable, you will get this sound. Same with that, same with any other, just copper, 2.5 millimeter speaker cable. 2.5 millimeter is the diameter of each strain, by the way. And a lot of information on the internet or on the product pages, oh, they use special conductors. With this price point, doesn't matter. Bullshit. It's just good cable. It is not expensive. Same price or maybe even cheaper than that one. This is more expensive because it has silver in it. And silver is a little bit of a different conductor than, well, oxidized free copper. So you will get a little bit of a different sound with this. And that's why I bought this, because I wanted to see if I can change the sound of my system a little bit. And I have this cable on my center channel. I've had that cable, and this cable on that center channel. And I got the same sound with these two, but I like the sound with this a little bit more, because it is a little bit more, I don't know, focused, a little bit more detail. A little bit more detail. Sound stage doesn't change because it's just a single speaker. It doesn't open up or anything. Just a little bit more detail, because the conductor is a little bit different. And with that combination, that center channel, the placement, the amp, this speaker cable just brought it up to the point. Maybe a little bit extra sprinkling on the top, where I thought, yeah, this is yeah, I like this cable better than those two. But these are fine. These are fine, fine cables. Then we get into the high-end stuff. I will open up my PC and I'll show you this cable. This is AudioQuest Rocket 44. This is expensive. For this setup that I have here, 2x3 meters, the other one is still connected to my speakers here. This is expensive. About 700 to 800 euros for this configuration. Length matters. You can have it by wire, by ampable. They get expensive. Let me show you. AudioQuest Rocket 44 is the highest of the Rocket line, I believe. Not really sure. Do I still have it open? Yeah. You can buy Rocket 44 in bare wire, just like this and that and this. 70 euros a meter. You can see it, I believe. It has solid copper conductors. It has, well, that particular design, etc. And I am not some electrical engineer, so I don't really care about the whole design, etc. Kimber cables is, well, really into the particular design of speaker cables. And Kimber cable is one of the cables I would love to try. Kimber cable select is... It's nice looking. But if I like the sound better than my Rocket 44 from AudioQuest, I don't know. But this is just bare wire. It has solid copper conductors, and that's solid. When you get this, it's really stiff. It's stiff. Stiffer than this. This is just floppy. This is stiff. Because it has solid copper conductors. That's why it's so expensive. Not because it's fairy dust or magic or anything. No, it is 70 euros a meter because it has solid copper inside. That's where the money went. Now, why is this more expensive than that? Well, it's because it has been finished, braided beautifully, expensive banana plugs. It's finished. It's a finished cable. And I get it. Some people don't want to buy for that, or they want to finish with their own type of materials. And that's why I like this so much, because you can buy that cable for 70 euros a meter, which isn't out of everybody's price range. If you're a real audiophile and you are at a point where I am, you're happy with your system, yeah, you could buy, invest in that. And maybe not spend so much on the finishing on this. If you don't care, you can just buy that cable. You will get the same performance when you finish it with good quality banana plugs like this. Because banana plugs and connections are also really important with cables. If you have good quality banana plugs on your cables, if you have good quality spades or anything, it will make a difference versus just simple bare wire. If you will finish this with banana plugs, you will also notice a difference in the connection. Everything will come a little bit more into focus, in my opinion. Bare wire is fine, but if you compare the same cable with or without quality banana plugs, not the cheap 1 euro stuff, quality banana plugs, I'm not saying 60 euros a plug, but decent quality banana plugs, you will notice a difference. Everything will become a little bit more focused. When you have a lens on a camera, for instance, you're trying to take a picture and it's just not in zoom properly, or just not focused enough, then you will add banana plugs to your cable and everything will become just a little bit more clear. Not 20 or 50% more, no, just that little bit extra. And that's cables for me. It's just a little bit more extra until you get to this. Because it's a really different type of material. It has solid copper conductors, really high quality banana plugs. Yeah, you will notice a big difference between this or that. Or you can choose the middle way. Ludica Audio. They say it's made in Europe. It's actually not. It's made in China. Because I have found the manufacturer in China who made these. But the banana plugs on this, my opinion, better quality than the AudioQuests. Because they are locking banana plugs, really amazing finish. Yeah, I have had some problems with this, etc. And we will not get into that. But it's really beautiful, thick. I believe this is actual coaxial cable inside. But it's metal all the way around, metal banana plugs, locking banana plugs, really, really nice, thick, heavy. How much? 150 euros for 2 times 3.5 meters. That's right. That's the cable that I got after I went. Well, I wanted a good cable. I wanted to get rid of these. I wanted to get a high-end audio cable that's good quality, banana plugs, and looks good. Cables are a bit of jewelry for your system. And that's why cables don't come on the first line of, well, important things in your system. Equipment should be the most important thing. Cables will come later. If you have decent, good quality cables to start with, cables will come later. But if you want to tune your system, speaker cables, in my opinion, are the way to go, because they can change sound just a little bit that you will like your system more. So, this is a good quality cable, and I still use it on my TNAs. I didn't connect it because the TNAs have the binding posts on the bottom and they are 35 kilos a piece, and I'm not gonna pick them up because I can't lift them on my own. Well, I can lift 35 kilos, but try lifting 35 kilos in about 1.5 meters of volume. Really difficult. But it's a good quality. It has a nice braiding going on. It has good quality connections, banana plugs. I opened one of these up and they have that solder point on them to make good connection with the plugs. And the shielding is nice. And that's also really important. You want shielding on your cables, because all of the, different waveforms, for instance, FM and AM, and also the voltage that leaks from power cords. You can actually measure that with your little multimeter. I did that because, well, cables leak. Power cables leak. And sometimes that can be picked up in your speaker cables, and you don't want that. It can translate to noise in your speakers. When you put your ear next to the speaker, I have my equipment off, so you won't hear it, but you could hear noise. And if you get cables with shielding, power cords with shielding, interconnects with shielding, speaker cables with shielding, that will help get rid of that buzzing, that noise in your speakers, sometimes. So, is there a really big difference between this, 700 euro, 800 euro, depending on what you're going with, speaker cable versus that one? Yes. Yes, there is. How so? Well, the difference is more so than going from this to this. With this, you really upgrade your system. When you go with something like this, which has a solid conductor inside of it, your system will become a little bit more dynamic and the things will separate better. Instruments, vocals, different layers of the music will come forward better. When I went from this to that, the difference was huge. Huge, huge difference. I wouldn't say I would, well, I thought I was getting new speakers, but I finally had the idea of, okay, this is what my speakers are capable of. It was a really big difference. Going from a good quality shielded with good connections cable to, well, from something like this, which is decent, but if you have a high-end setup, you want a good quality cable. I'm not saying spend thousands on cables, because in my opinion, that's a little bit dumb. Spend a good amount of money on cables if you have your system that you're happy with. But yeah, I still went with this. Why? Well, because AudioQuest gave them to me. Same with all my AudioQuest cables. Don't leave. This is not a sponsored video. I hate reviewers. I hate people who talk about audio and just, well, say nice words about the equipment because they, got it sent for free. And they want to please everybody so they can get more. No. If I would get a product and I would review it for the site where I review equipment for, hi-fi.nl, I would say it's rubbish. But the thing is, at least in my opinion, the people that send equipment to the reviews at hi-fi.nl don't, do it. There aren't any rubbish, real rubbish products on the site because they won't just get featured. It's kind of like this. If you make a bad product, would you send it to reviewers? No, of course not. You would pay them to make good reviews, and some sites do that, yes. But I know for a fact, HiFi.nl doesn't do that. Because if you look on the site, you will not find the shit products. You will find good quality products from brands that I, have known in the audio industry for years. Speakers from Kef, amps from Mark Levinson, Sonos Faber speakers, Monitor Audio, SVS is a new player in the ballpark because they make good quality products. And this is the way it is. If you make shit products, you won't get featured on a site like that. And if you will get featured on a site like that, that site will quickly be known as a shit website. So that's just the thing. We won't talk about things that we don't like. Or things that, well, we will talk about things that we don't like, but we won't talk about shit products because, well, what's the point? So, this is a good quality product. If this was a shit product, of course, I would tell you. Because, well, it's made by a really big manufacturer, but a big manufacturer who puts out a shit product, that's not really a thing in the hi-fi industry. Of course, things change. I mean, Sonos Faber has done a couple of things in the past which were a little bit more controversial, but those things will get out and are on the internet and are on review websites. But Audio Quest, for instance, won't put out a cable that costs I don't know how much money but is bad. No, they won't. And the thing with cables is just, well, it's also a little bit personal. A little bit, if it looks expensive, you may think it sounds expensive. For instance, digital cables. These are analog cables. Yeah, this is a rant of a video. But if you have digital cables, it either works or it doesn't. Analog cables are different because they can have problems with, interference from outside. That's why shielding is important. Digital either works or it doesn't. Optical cables work if they have something wrong with them, they don't. HDMI, exact same thing. So expensive optical cables, expensive USB cables, expensive HDMI cables, I do not believe in that. And different sites have done tests with expensive USB cables, AudioQuest, expensive HDMI cables, Monster for example, and they said, no, we don't notice any difference. We measured, we don't notice any difference. And we did blind tests, and we didn't notice any difference. And the people who say cables don't make a difference, just go for measurements and don't go, don't go and listen to them. And I have had experience. I bought expensive USB cables. I bought expensive HDMI cables. And I didn't notice a single difference. And the beautiful thing about my setup is I could hook two HDMI cables from my receiver to my TV and just switch inputs. And just see the picture, the same picture but different inputs and outputs. Didn't notice any difference. Blind test with people, didn't notice any difference. Fine. New cable, didn't notice any difference. So, USB cables, exact same thing. Just use two USB cables from your system to the DAC, switch it out. No, not a difference. Audio cables, speak cables, analog cables, yeah, of course. Because there's not a digital signal going through there. It's not ones and zeros. It's different stuff that runs through here. Current, voltage, everything that makes sound go. So, yes, the difference with this cable is here because it uses a different material. And, well, Kimber cables also uses particular designs and shielding in internal, etc. But when you get cables, and they say shit like, we have different strands in here for the high frequencies, the mid frequencies, and the low frequencies. That's not how it works, mate. Because the signal goes through here, and just goes through the cable. You can't, send certain signal types to different strains if you don't use, a resistance or a controller or something to control those signals going through the cable. So that's just bullshit. And a lot of people do not believe in cable flow. For instance, this side will say amp, and well, you see a little arrow here. This also says left amp, and a signal that goes through here, and this says speaker with an arrow going that way, and well, red and black. But the thing is, I believe in cable flow. Why do I believe in cable flow? Well, because everything goes through here and all the way around. And I believe that if you run a cable for a long while, in the same position, when the signal comes in here and goes through there, I believe it will make a difference whether the signal flows for a long time that way, and then certainly change it out and it has to flow that way. I do believe it makes a difference because it is logical. Because the electrons that need to run through it can have resistance in the way. I know that. And the less resistance there is, the easier they will flow. And I believe that after a long while of those electrons flowing through this cable in the same direction, they won't like it as much if you would switch the cable around. If you would switch the cable around every so often, and 1 month here, 1 month, it wouldn't matter. But if you run it for a long while, let's say 2-3 years in that same lineup, and you would change it, it would be possible to hear a change. Depending on your amp, depending on your ears, depending on the speakers that you use, depending on all type of different situations. But I believe that would make there would be a difference. It won't make a difference saying this is for the left speaker and a different cable is for the right speaker. That won't make a difference because it's just a signal. The signal going to that speaker is not different than going to that speaker. It's the same signal, otherwise the speakers would sound different. But I believe that has something to do with the connections, because I haven't really confirmed this, but looking at it, I believe in order for the solid copper leads in here to not get tangled, because well, they can break and you don't want that. You have also these connectors, etc. But yeah, crossing them over like this isn't really beneficial. So I believe the connections on the left speaker are in different places than the right speaker. That's what I mean by that, if anybody is wondering. I haven't really confirmed that, but that's the only thing I can, guess. Because if this would have hooked up to the left speaker or to the right speaker, it doesn't make a difference because it's still a plus and minus going in and going through the cable. Whether this end is connected for a long time to the speaker or this end is connected to a long time for the speaker and then you change it around, I would believe it would make a difference. No, I have not tested it yet. I am also not gonna test it. Just hook it up and just forget about it. But when you rip your whole system apart, you need to move or anything, and then you put your system all back together, I believe when you mix up those things could make a difference. That's probably why they put it on there. All right, that is my little rant about speaker cables. I have no idea how long this video is, probably long. But yeah, the point of this whole video is, if you want to tune your system, speaker cables are amazing. Do not buy fairy dust, buy engineering. This is solid copper conductors. That's why they're 70 euros a meter. They are finished beautifully with good quality banana plugs, good quality rubber splitters. That's why the finished cable costs more than if you would buy it, just unfinished for a meter or six. This is fine when you start out with your system. This might be even be fine when you have your final system. But don't use a lamp cable, because I've seen a lot of sites say, oh, that is fine. No, that is not fine, because there is no shielding in there. It's just really thin. It's prone to get filled with all kinds of signals that you don't want, and you will probably, when you put your ear next to your speaker, you will probably hear a little bit of buzzing, because I have had that experience using thin wire on speakers and power cables and everything, if you look behind here, I don't know if you can see, there is a nest of cables, power cables. I've organized everything as good as possible for the power cables not to come into direct contact with the speaker cables, because that is bad. Because power cables leak voltage and you don't want speaker cables picking that up, because that can result in buzzing in your speakers. And that's why you buy cables with good shielding and good connectors, because that will lower that noise floor. No, your speakers won't sound completely different. It will tune your system a bit. Maybe add more bass. Maybe give a little bit more in terms of well, the highs, etc. And it's also really amp dependent. This is a really heavy duty power amp. If you have one of those shitty amps or maybe a shitty receiver, you won't notice the big difference when you hook up a cable like this. But an amplifier is an amplifier. No, no. That amp sounds better, but different than that amp. And the amps in that thing sound different than my X4000 Denon. And the amps in my X4000 Denon sounded different than in my Onkyo amp. I also had a Quad 606 amp. Also sounded different. And that's the whole thing. Sometimes cables work differently in different systems. So if cables don't work for your system, but they do work in somebody else's system, if you would get this and you wouldn't notice a difference from going from this to this, it's either your ears or your system, my friend. Because if you can't detect this cable in your system versus this cable or this cable in your system, I'm sorry, but there's something wrong. I've had multiple people here testing things with me, listening, and I always do blind tests because, well, I like doing blind tests with people. And they couldn't really point out what has changed because they aren't really familiar with my system. But I just asked the question, does it sound different? The answer is always, well, yes. Or, well, if I would hook up this versus this, they would say, not really. I've done tests. If you have not done tests for yourself, you aren't supposed to have an opinion on this matter. If you have no experience driving a Ferrari, how can you say Ferraris are shit? I've driven one. How does somebody know who doesn't have driven one how that car would feel? It's simple, really. But you don't need to spend 700 euros on good quality speaker cables. I'm not saying that. I'm saying put your money in your system. Speakers, amps, sources. That's where your money should go. But if you want to fine tune your system, a cable like this will make you happy, my friends. You won't need to spend 700 euros on that cable. I got given that cable from AudioQuest because I make reviews for a hi-fi website. And thank you, AudioQuest. Thank you for the people at hi-fi.nl for providing me with that cable. I really do like it. And I just told you, I like it. But you don't need that cable to make you happy. Those cables right there, yes, they sound good. And they will probably make the average audiophile happy. But if you want to fine-tune your system, and you just want beautiful-looking cables, you can either finish them yourself for cheap, or you can just search for, well, second-hand cables, or this, a good conductor with good shielding, beautiful connectors, good splitter. This is perfectly fine. That's why I have it hooked up to my more expensive TNAs than my quads. Simply because when I get speakers to review, I want to use my AudioQuest cables, because I know those are better cables than this. Probably. I haven't done A-B testing with that one and that one yet. But I could tell straight up, because I listened to music when this cable was on, and then I got that cable and then I switched them out, I could hear a difference. So I know there is a difference. But I haven't done A-B testing with people yet because of the current situation in the world and blah, 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 blah. But this is a good cable. But I do not want to use it for, well, my reviews, etc. So that's why I have it hooked up to my TNA, because the connections are on the bottom of that speaker. So if I want to, well, plug in a different speaker that comes here, I want to use my best cable, which is that AudioQuest. And I'm sorry, but it's not that. It's a beautiful cable. Beautiful. Sounds beautiful. but it's not that audio quest. And well, that's 7 times the price or 5 times the price of this, so of course that should sound better. But does it sound 5 times as good? No, my friend. But that's why I have that cable hooked up to my MB quads. But I would be perfectly fine hooking this up to my MB quads and that on my TNAs. I would be fine. But I want to use that cable when I get new speakers in, and MB quads does have the binding posts on the wire, so I can unhook them properly. Why they put the binding posts on the bottom, it's German. They also have it. It's German. What can I say? Friends, thank you for watching. Long video, but I wanted to make this. I want to get my story out. I want to get my experience out. I want to talk about these things. If you have, well, an opinion, I would like you to post it down below. But explain your opinion. Don't say, cables are bullshit. You don't know anything, man. Say why you believe that. Because it is important to talk about this stuff. Because we can all agree, engineering matters. Not fairy dust. And if I would have a cable here that costs 10,000 euros, I would shit all over it probably, unless it is made out of pure solid gold with diamonds stitched on it. Because why the hell would you spend 10,000 euros on speaker cables? I know they're out there. AudioQuest makes really expensive speaker cables. But why would you spend that 10 grand on a different set of speakers, not on cables? For a person who has a job and has his dream system, 700 is not much to spend on good quality speaker cables. They will call back. 700 euros is not much to spend on speaker cables. If you have an audio system that you have worked all your life on and you have really expensive speakers and amps and decks and all the stuff, then it's not expensive. But don't think about spending more than even a grand on speaker cables. I mean, come on, man. You can get, I don't know, so much records. A different record player, for instance. A different amp. Another set of speakers. A different set of speakers to switch between will make you more happy than spending 1,000 on speaker cables. Spend the money to where you can get good quality speaker cables. That's important. And I believe these audio quests are. And if you don't want to spend the full blow on new cables, buy them second hand. Or buy the bare wire version of this. That's what I would have done probably, and just finished them myself. If AudioQuest wouldn't have sent me these, I would have probably not bought these. I would have probably bought the bare wire version. Because the Rocket 33, 22 and a Rocket 11, I believe, is also out there. Everybody says they sound beautiful. Not just one or two websites, no, the whole internet says AudioQuest make good speaker cables. So this is just, well, me confirming that it is. But I'm not saying those are rubbish. I'm certainly not saying those are rubbish. If you want value for money, you need to buy those. Because yes, those are really that much better than these. Because of the connectors, the shielding, the whole thing is a evolution going from this to this. But going from that to this, it's just the material that matters, really. What different material it has. And that's my 2 cents about cables. If you have questions, let me know. I will probably talk about power cords and interconnects next. That will be probably one video, or I will split things up. But this is a long video, because this is this is a topic that is, well, controversial for a lot of people. And the only thing I can say is, if you doubt cables or you don't, well, believe in them, A/B test them. A/B test the cables. Go to your dealer, just buy them, A/B test them, send back the things that you don't believe. I wanted to understand cables, so I bought those. And then I knew, okay, they make a difference. But I would have been happy with those for the rest of my life. Probably would have bought AudioQuest Rocket sometime. Maybe the 33, not the 44, I think. But well, thanks to AudioQuest for hooking me up, I guess. RCA cables are a little bit different, because I have RCA cables on there that cost 400 euros. And RCA cables that cost 25, bottom on discount. I have a little bit different opinion on those. But that's interesting. But this is how I think about speaker cables. It's a long video, yes. But there are a lot of things to talk about. Thanks for watching. And I'll catch you next time. Bye.